sentence. person because often it is kind of a safety issue to like reject advances, etc. But there is like safe ways to do that. And this isn't just having boundaries in like superficial settings like that. It also means with your actual relationships, whether it's friendships, significant others, dates, like all of that, even at work, or with yourself. Like, I often have to set boundaries for myself, for simple things like brushing my teeth. Sometimes I get really lazy and I'm like, I'm gonna give myself a free pass and just go to bed and then brush my teeth in the morning. Small things like that, then what am I going to have discipline for? Like, it's a small practice to make myself, you know, do my skincare, take care of my teeth, but the like compound effect is much more important, I think. So practice having boundaries as many ways as you can, but also that comes with the caveat of like, I feel like a lot of people these days will be like, oh, I'm gonna cut off this person because they're depressed and their energy is bringing me down. And I don't necessarily think that cutting people off is a boundary. It's not great to just like go cutting people off all around. Yeah. The next point is number 7, and it's expand your vocabulary. This is another one that I am constantly working on. So filler words, that's a big problem for me, and I especially notice it when I'm setting. I think avoiding slang and curse words is a good idea. And even just when you're meeting people in a casual setting, if you don't want to portray yourself as like kind of ditzy, Stay present and make eye contact. much more conducive to like an elevated lifestyle, and it's to the